Hello and welcome to the 33rd video in this beginner's guide to Adobe After Effects. In this tutorial, we are going to kick off our project and I'm going to demonstrate a number of procedures to follow in After Effects. In this video, we are going to start with the first section of the video presentation. We are going to look at how to create the first section and animate type and graphic elements. In this video, we are going to create this animated type with a map background image. So in this video, we are going to be covering the following topics: animating type and animating an image. So let's get into it. So here I am where we left off in the previous episode, where we set up a new document in After Effects. Now, if you're following along for the first time, I suggest going back to the previous episode where we set up this document ready to start our video presentation. Now, if you're continuing on from the last episode, make sure you have your document open ready. So with our document open, let's proceed. So let's start by creating our first composition. So I'll use the keyboard shortcut here and press Command N on Mac or Control N on PC. Upon click, we will get a new comp settings box. So from here, I will name it Main Comp. For the preset, I will set this to HD TV 1080-25. Now this will set the dimensions to 1920 by 1080 and the frame rate to 25. For the resolution, I'll set this to full. And for the duration, I'll make sure this is set to 1 minute 20 seconds. So that's 0, colon, 0, 1, colon, 2, 0, colon, 0, 0. I'll set the background color to black and click OK. Upon click, the new comp will open, and if we look in the project panel, we can see it has appeared. And I'll quickly drag this comp into the comp folder. And I'll click on the square color box and click red. So with the comp ready, let's start to bring in our media. So if I now come into Photoshop and look back at my design, I can see the design I created for my first frame. This is a scene with a map in the background, the type in the middle, and these five destination pins around. Now if you want to check this out, remember you can open it. With the project folder open, click into the S3 Create a Project folder, and then into folder 31, Plan and Design, then into folder 1, Plan and Design, then into the Design folder and open the Project Design Photoshop document. So back in After Effects, I'm going to start by creating my background layer. To do this, I'll create a solid layer. So I'll press Command Y on Mac or Control Y on PC, and up will pop the solid settings. So here I'll make sure the width and height is the same as my comp, 1920 by 1080, and I'll come down to set my color. So I'll quickly jump into Photoshop. I'll come over to the Tools menu and select the eyedropper tool. With this, I'll click on the dark blue. Then I'll click on the color at the bottom of the Tools menu. I'll copy the hex value at the bottom of the color picker menu. Then back in After Effects, I'll click on the colored box. Up will pop the solid color, and I'll come into the hex value and paste the value I just copied from Photoshop. And I'll click OK. Then click OK on the solid setting. And now I have a new solid layer in my timeline. Now, when you create a solid, it will span the entire length of the comp. For now, this is not an issue, so I'll just leave it as it is. Next, I'll come down and click on the colored square for the solid layer and select Peach. Now, when you create a solid for the first time, you will notice a new folder appear in the project panel called Solids. In here will be the solid we just created. So let's click and drag this folder up and into the Assets folder, and I'll place it into the Images folder. Nice. So let's now bring in the map image. So with the project folder open, click into folder 2, Project Assets, then into the Images folder, then into the JPEG folder, then into the Location folder, and you will see the London.jpg. Now simply click and drag the image into the project panel in After Effects, and in After Effects we will see our new image asset ready to use. So before I do anything else, I'll quickly click and drag this new JPEG image into the JPEG folder in the Image folder. So now we are going to select the image and place it into our comp. We can do this really easy by using the keyboard shortcut. So with the image selected in the project panel, press Command forward slash on Mac or Control forward slash on PC. This will place the map image into the comp at the top of the layer stack in the timeline panel. So right now, this image is too big for the frame. So I'll press S on the keyboard and that will reveal the scale settings on the layer. So I'll come down and click and drag on the scale settings and bring the image down until it fits the frame like so. Okay, so right now this is a black and white image. Now looking back in Photoshop at my design, the map blends nicely with the background blue. So back in After Effects, we can use a blending mode. So I'll come over to the file name and look for the blending mode option for this layer. If you cannot see it, simply right click on the column headers, come down to column and make sure modes is ticked. So I'll click on the blending mode option for the London map image layer and select screen. Upon click, this will blend with the background blue color nicely. However, it's a bit bright. I want to tone this map down a bit. So this time I'll press T on the keyboard to reveal the opacity settings. I'll come across and drag the settings down to 30%. So now the map background is looking pretty good there, the same as my design. Next, I'll come down and click on the colored square for my image layer and select yellow. So next, I'm going to bring in the type layer. So looking back at my design in Photoshop, I can see that for the first frame, we have the words five top places in big bold type. So back in After Effects, I'll press Command T on Mac or Control T on PC to activate the type tool. So I'll click somewhere over on the left hand side once, and then I'll come over to the right and click on the character panel. So I'll set my font to size 150. I'll click on the color and select a white color, and I'll set the font to Lemon Milk Regular. I'll click back onto the comp and type five top places dot dot dot. Now, if you don't have the font installed, you can get this font online for free. With the project folder open, click into folder 2, Project Assets, then into the typeface folder. In here, you will find an instructions document that will lead you to the font to download. Once installed, you can continue. So I'll come up to my type and double click on it to select it. Next, I'll come over to the right and click on the paragraph panel. If you cannot see it, come up to Window, scroll down and click on Paragraph. And in this panel, I'll click on the Center Type button. Once clicked, I'll click on the Selection tool in the Tools menu and click and drag my type into the center. So now I want to make sure my type is set to the middle. So I'll come and select my solid layer at the bottom in the Timeline panel. And now I can see the square bounding box around it, with the horizontal midpoint and the vertical midpoint. Now, if you cannot see the bounding box, simply press Command-Shift-H on Mac or Control-Shift-H on PC to toggle the visibility of the bounding box. So with the squares around, we can see where the center point is. Next, I'll press Command-R on Mac or Control-R on PC to reveal the rulers. Next, I'll drag a guide out from the left and place it right in the center point like so. And while I'm at it, I'll drag one from the top as well to meet in the middle. So just like that, we now have two guides. So I'll press Command-R on Mac or Control-R on PC again to remove the rulers and click on the type layer to select it. So with the visible bounding box around my type, I'll align it to the center of the comp like so. Perfect. So right now I can see that my anchor point is at the bottom of the type. Now I don't want this at the bottom. I need this to be in the center. So I'll come up to Layer, down to Transform, and I'll come over and click Center Anchor Point in Layer Content. Upon click, my anchor point will be right in the middle, right where I want it. So that's my type sorted. So next, I'll come down and click on the colored square for my type layer and select green. So now in the timeline, I have my new type layer and notice that it spans the entire length of the comp. Now this happens by default when you create a type layer. For now, we will just leave it as it is. So now I'm happy my type is in the center of the comp. I can press Command colon on Mac or Control colon on PC to toggle away the guides. So now my type and map image is in place, I want to animate them. For the type, I want a zoom effect in with a subtle expansion afterwards. And for the map image, I want to capture a nice subtle zoom behind. So first, I'll place my time indicator at around 5 seconds on the timeline, and I'll press N to set the end of the workspace area. Then I'll zoom in so I can focus on just this work area. So I'll start by dragging my time indicator right to the start of the comp. I'll select the type layer and press S to activate the scale settings. I'll click the stopwatch icon to place my first scale keyframe. Then I'll move my time indicator across the timeline to about 0.5 seconds and click on the diamond icon to add a second scale keyframe. Next, I'll drag the time indicator back to the start of the timeline, making sure it's directly above the first keyframe. With the time indicator above the first keyframe, I'll come and drag the scale of the type down to around 15%. So now the type is really small. Now, if I drag the time indicator between these frames, we can see the animation sequence. So next, I want to add an effect that makes the type keep expanding after it zooms in. So I'll move the time indicator over to 4 seconds and I'll click and drag the scale settings up to around 130%. So I'll press spacebar to activate preview, and that is looking just fine. The type zooms in and then continues to expand nicely afterwards, up to 4 seconds. So I'll press spacebar to stop the preview. So next, I want to add an effect to my type so it fades in on zoom. So first, I'll move my time indicator towards the second frame, holding shift to snap my time indicator to the keyframe. With the time indicator on top of the second keyframe, I'll press T to activate the opacity settings for the layer. Next, I'll come down and click the stopwatch to add my first opacity keyframe. Next, I'll drag my time indicator right back to the start of the timeline, and then click and drag the opacity settings to 0. Upon doing this, it will create a new keyframe. I'll press spacebar to activate preview, and that is looking pretty cool. The type fades in on zoom and expands nicely. So I'll press spacebar to stop. So now, with the layer selected, I'll press U on the keyboard to reveal all the frames for the layer. Now this animation is almost complete. What I will do now is smooth out the zoom part of the animation with some easing. So I'll come down and focus on the scaling keyframes. So I'll right click on the first scale keyframe, I'll come down to keyframe assistance and add easy ease out. Then I'll right click on the second scale keyframe, I'll come down to keyframe assistance and add easy ease in. So I'll drag my time indicator to the start of the timeline and press spacebar to activate preview. And now we can see that the zoom animation is a little more fluid. Perfect. So next, I want to animate the background. So as the type zooms in and expands, so does the background. So I'll drag the time indicator back to the start of the comp, and I'll select the London map layer and press S to activate the scale settings. I'll click the stopwatch icon to add a scale keyframe, then I'll drag the time indicator across to 4 seconds and come down and drag out the scale, expanding the image just slightly. I'll press spacebar to activate preview, and that is looking pretty cool. The image is expanding nicely behind the type, creating this nice sequence. So this is the first part of the animated sequence for the introduction section. At this point, I would recommend saving your document so we can continue in the next episode. So looking back at the Photoshop design, we can see these 5 destination pins around the type. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to animate a bouncing pin, which we will then add around the type to complete the first part of the intro animation sequence. See you in the next video.